out. In other words, you could predict what the weather was going to happen in sort of Seattle region, maybe the Puget Sound region. And you could tell what big storms were coming and whether it was likely to be sunny and dry or anything like that. But you're not going to get any sense as to like, well, what's going to happen in Bothell? Because it was generalized over this much, much, much wider area, because that's the grid cell size. So as computing power increased and storage increased, you could rewrite models with smaller grid spacing and get better results and more accurate forecasts. This is just another graph that kind of shows you the same thing for that one. Just layers of grid cells. And then there's another one. Anybody heard of a company named Cray? It's one of the most important computing companies that no one's ever heard of. They were the inventors of the first supercomputer, and they're still creating supercomputers today. And they're based in Seattle. And no one knows about it because it's a highly specialized. They're not for consumers. I mean, these are computers that essentially go to governments, or even to universities or university collaborations or something like that. Inside these things are hundreds of thousands of processors. I mean, this one, which is the one that was bought by the National Weather Service most recently, is each of those towers is 2.5 petaflops, petaflops. And I never remember what a petaflop is, so I'm going to look it up real quick. A unit of computing speed equal to 1,000 million floating point operations per second. 10 to the 15 operations, computing operations every second. That was each one of these. So it's a tremendous amount of computing speed. And that's what it takes to run weather models. All right. Anybody ever play this game? I don't know why I asked, because no one ever has. I think my family has only owned the only one. And I don't know how I'm going to do this without, I think I might just ask you guys to stand up in a minute. The idea behind Bumperlina was a super fun game for kids. Actually, it was a super fun game for me, too. It's good for up to three players.